folks, I have to really think and make sure I phrase this properly. When is America, and in particular the people of Alabama, and in particular the black people in Alabama, when are they going to stand up and be counted? Okay? I know that you're aware of the race for Senate down in the state of Alabama. And you may be aware that Judge Roy Moore basically is a Trump clone. You may also be aware that he is an accused pedophile. He basically trolled young girls from as young as 14 years old. His current wife, he basically targeted her when she was 16, dated her, okay, when she was 18 or so, continued, I guess, to date her after, while she was still married to her first husband, and finally married her at 24. So this pedophile chased this young girl from the age of 16. This guy has a preponderance of chasing babies and should be nowhere near federal office. He should not have actually been able to make it to a judge. He should have been disbarred as a district attorney. But none of that matters to a bunch of people down in Alabama. But now this particular story should matter to all black people in the state of Alabama. This man believes that America was great. Let me rephrase that. America was lastly great during the time of slavery, obviously before 1865. Here's another story that mainstream media won't pick up.
Y'all, now we already know Roy Moore ignorant and crazy. But check this out, y'all. Roy Moore, just the other day on the campaign trail, said this: the last time that America was great was when we had slavery. Y'all, seriously, he was in Florence, Alabama. It took place more than 2 months ago, and he was talking about, again, when he's, again, it's weird, the last time America was great. So here's the story. This is AL.com. So basically what happened was he was talking about in terms of where they are in terms of the state of the family. And he said that America was great when families were united, quote, even though we had slavery. They cared for one another. Our families were strong. Our country had a direction.
It's unfortunate. It's racist. That's unfortunate, and he should be ashamed.
That's his true colors. But the sad thing is, he's still going to win with 60% of the vote in Alabama. And the fact is, Alabama has a 25% black population, and even with that, he is still going to win. Even with an accusation of being a pedophile, or even with a positive statement on slavery, even with pulling a gun out during a campaign rally.
Right.
And dressing up like, you know,
like Howdy Doody.
Yeah, and he's still going to win.
Now, at the same rally, he also referred to Native Americans as ape and Asians as reds and yellows, according to the Los Angeles Times. Tiffany, what you have, first of all, it's stunning to me, you know, well, let's think about this. The last time America was great, because our families were together, we were strong, was during slavery. So ever since, so essentially, when slaves were free, America went to hell. Now remember, Donald Trump has also essentially said how America was great back in the 1950s. See, this is the thing that when you talk about the difference between being black. Black in America, White in America. The current commission report, 50th anniversary is going to be next year, which where they examine the cause of the riots, where they say there are two Americas, one white, one black. This is the case. When you hear that, Bob Dole's campaign against Bill Clinton 1996, where he kept hearkening back to the old days, black folks were like, dude, they were not great for us. You have white Americans who have this infatuation with how things used to be, as if what was happening to us just a little side thing.
Yeah, I think the saddest part of all of this is even though Roy Moore has made these comments and obviously his accusations against pursuing teenagers, he's still given a platform at some black churches across Alabama and still given the opportunity to speak. So I do wonder what it's going to take for black people in Alabama to get motivated and encouraged to rally around Doug Jones, the Democratic candidate. Also, I think this highlights is very consistent with what the president says. And I do think, to your point, Roland, that no, times are not great for us. So when people do say, make America great again, this is the same thing that brought down Senator Trent Lott at the time. And politicians, like you said, Bob Dole made similar claims. It's kind of a ridiculous notion. And I think for us as black people, we've always had to consider somebody else's perspective. We've always had to consider how white America looks at things because it's, you know, the supremacy factor. White America never has to do that with black people. Their vision is so tunneled. They never have to personally take on our struggles or what we experience. So because they don't, they immediately dismiss it as playing the race card or just something that they don't understand, so they sweep it under the rug. And until white America says, yes, this is the bloodstain on the democracy of this country that we have to address, acknowledge, and try to make right, I think these candidates will continue to get a free pass.
Michael, here's the deal. If you are black in Alabama, I don't care if you think that no matter what happens, Roy Moore is going to win. If black folks in Alabama should be saying, we want to see a minimum 75% turnout, don't care. Because the bottom line is, he might not win. You never know how this thing is going to break. You don't know what's going to happen with white women in these suburbs. Are they just going to be so offended by it? But the bottom line is this here, and this is what I don't understand. I don't want to hear anything from any black person in Alabama of all states when it comes to voting. My deal is, I don't care who you are, if you black in Alabama, you should be personally dragging 10 people to the poll and saying, I mean, literally pulling a Harriet Tubman, who pulled her gun out on some folk, like, look, this fool cannot be our United States Senator.
I mean, if you have any reason to vote next Tuesday, this is the reason. And if it rains, if something's wrong with your plumbing, if you don't have a babysitter, you need to figure it out and get to the polls. And a quick fact check on his quote, because historically, his quote isn't accurate. Our black families during slavery were broken up. We were not together.
Right.
Different from other immigrant groups that did stay together. Ours were not. So he was not factually correct. That was not the best time for us because our families were being split every single day.
He wasn't talking about you. He said that when our families were united, he wasn't talking about
you. Oh, I'm sorry.
As they say, what now one of us he was talking about.
But I think it's important to understand how dangerous commentary like this is, because this is often what happens when you're dealing with downtrodden people. Alabama has one of the highest white poverty rates in the country, the lowest health care, lowest educational rates. So what happens with downtrodden groups, if you look at what Germany did in the 1930s, is that you get to nostalgia. You talk about the great empire that was. You talk about this Germania. You talk about Charlemagne the Great. You talk about things like that to make people harken back to this mythical time when everything was better. If we can just go back there, that's when extremism rises, and that's what Roy Moore is harkening back to. That's the frightening thing about these discussions.
And I really wish white folks in Alabama who know how to read. But if you don't have to, you could actually listen. Well, go listen to the speech that Dr. King gave in Montgomery after the march from Selma. I think it was March 25th, 1965. And in that particular speech, he talked about, he laid out what took place post-Civil War. He talked about the fact that you did not have this great separation between races. He said, and what ended up happening was, whites and blacks united over the issue of wages. And what ended up happening was white plantation owners said, no, we can't have this. In that speech, folks, go listen to it. Dr. King said how mass media was used to separate and to get white, poor whites to understand that, no, we're the same, you not like them. And then that coalition that existed between poor whites and freed slaves was broken up. And then, of course, with the Great Compromise of 1877, when Jim Crow laws were put in place, that's what cemented that deal. But the reality is that was a period of history, Roy Moore, right after slavery, where you literally had those Reconstruction Amendments, the 12 years of Reconstruction, where you had those moments where poor whites' lives actually got better because of the rights that free slaves were also fighting for. But they used white supremacy, and that's when it came in. I believe it was March 25th, 1965, Dr. King's speech in Montgomery after the March to Selma. Trust me, if you are poor and white in America, you might learn something. So if they can't read, just play the audio for them.
All right, so you just got a little bit of history and a little bit of homework to do for yourself. But y'all down in Alabama, Roland is 100% right. If for nothing else other than this particular statement, if you don't give a damn about a child molester, if you don't give a damn about a child predator, you know, that's on you, okay? But if you do give a damn about your people and how we are perceived, and I'm talking to black people right now, you need to get your behinds out there and vote against this man. I don't care win or lose, your voice needs to be heard. We need to show up at the polls in record numbers in Alabama to make it clear where we stand. And I believe if we do show up in record numbers, we will defeat this man.